Hi, I'm Dr. Fyodorova.
And I'm Dr. Lipnitsky.
And we're a part of the rehabilitation team at Pain Physicians New York. We're here to present to you a neck, upper back, and shoulder mobility and stability exercise video.
And as always, if you develop any pain or discomfort during this exercise routine, please stop them immediately and consult your rehabilitation specialist.
Enjoy the video.
Enjoy.
Michelle, first exercise, what we're going to do is you're going to lie straight, flat, your feet relaxed, but together. You're going to have your thumbs up position. And what you're going to do is you're going to elevate an arm alongside your head while concentrating on the breathing. You always want to breathe with the bottom two-thirds of your rib cage to allow the diaphragm to come down. So you're gonna belly breathe. So this part should come up. Okay, you're going to come back as far as you can, keeping the shoulder nice and relaxed. Touch the back, touch the floor, keep the elbow locked and come on back. And we're going to repeat 10 times on each side. So now do the same with the left. Great, that was one. Concentrate on the belly coming up, and now the right again. Second one coming. Great, come on back. Very good. Two, good. Three. Try to reach as far back as you can to really bring the shoulder into its full motion. That's five. And six. And seven. She's breathing in as she's bringing the arm back, breathing out on the way down. Number seven. Number eight. Number nine. And number 10. Full extension, belly out because you're taking a big breath in and come on back. Last one, very nice. This is the second exercise. This is, we're gonna work on neck rotation. So legs are aligned as before, arms are flat down beside you. What you're going to do is you're going to open up your full neck mobility by pushing down on the shoulder. And then you're going to turn your head to the right first, come to full rotation, and then bring it on back. Good, and then you're going to do the same thing with the opposite side. You're gonna bring down the left shoulder and rotate to the left. You're doing this exercise five times. So left, right is one, five times. Okay, ready? Let's go. Number two, pull down, rotate to the right, center, and then pull down with the left shoulder and rotate to the left. The same thing, pull down, keep that head nice and straight. Try not to reach down with your chin. Just neutral, straight over. That's it. Three. Pull down. Four. a little bit slower. To the right. Mm-hmm. Pull down with the left. And nice and easy to the left. Perfect. Okay. This is the third exercise. It's called the chin tuck exercise. So what we're going to do is Michelle is going to have a towel placed underneath her head, right in the little crevice where the head meets the neck, to kind of align the spine completely. Then what she's going to do, she's going to press down with her chin, and it's not a downward motion where the chin meets the chest. It's a suppression. So what she's doing is she's going to push with the base of the skull and bring the chin in and relax. She's going to hold it for 5 seconds, 5 times. So go ahead, Michelle, suppress. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and relax. Excellent. That's 2. Third one, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Perfect. Relax. So this is going to be the fourth one. Michelle, you want to make sure that the muscles up front, your sternocleidomastoid, is relaxed, and you want to use really the back of the head muscles to do this. Okay, so ready? 4, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and relax. Perfect. And one more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Very nice. Relax. The next exercise, it's going to be the head elevation. So what you're going to do is you're going to bend one knee. It does not matter which one. Place the foot flat and keep your knee bent. Okay. Then what you're going to do, the next thing you're going to do is you're going to kind of contract your belly. So to put your core on. Then you're going to do your chin tuck, which you practiced the exercise previous. And you're going to elevate to look at the knee without lifting your shoulder bones. Come on back. Excellent. You're not holding this time around. You're just coming up, doing the motion, and coming right back down. And we're going to repeat 10 times. Okay. This is number 2. Great. Come on back. Mm-hmm. So remember, core has to be on and chin tuck is in place. Okay. Number 3. Excellent. Mm-hmm. Number 4. Great. And 5. Very good. And 6. Mm-hmm. And 7. Remember to keep the chin tuck. Don't let it go. Uh-huh. Great. And number 8. Good. And 9. Very good. And 1 more, 10. Great. Now, to advance this exercise, when you've become proficient with it, you want to hold the position when you elevate for about 3 to 5 seconds. So Michelle is going to do it once just to demonstrate. She's gonna tuck the tummy, she's gonna do the chin tuck, and she's gonna hold for 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Fantastic. Very good. The next exercise is going to be the McGill curl up. The first thing you want to do is you want to bend the knee again. Does not matter which one, whatever is more comfortable. Very good. Keep it flat. Then you're going to position your hands behind your back, both of them. And what you're going to do is you're going to push down with your pelvis to eliminate the space between the floor and your lower back. You're going to rotate the pelvis to engage your core. Okay, then you're going to pull down your ribs. Very good. You're going to do your chin tuck to stabilize your neck. Fantastic. And you're going to lift up. This time you're going to elevate your scapula. So you're going to have your back bones come up off the ground. You don't have to hold again. You're just doing repetitions. We're going to do 10 of them. Okay. Just make sure that the pelvis is down, ribs are tucked, chin is down, and you come up. Number 2. Good. And 3. Good. And 4. Good. And five. Good. And six. Very nice. And seven. Good. And eight. Great. And nine. Very good. And the last one, 10. Excellent. This next exercise is going to be your preparation for the angel, for the wall angel, still lying down. So what you're going to do is you're going to bring your shoulder and your elbow to 90 degrees. Very good. Okay. And then what you're going to do is, the goal is to have your forearm lie completely flat on the floor. So again, you're going to compress your chest down and then come on all the way back as far as you can go without elevating the shoulder. So you want to keep the shoulders down and your scapula squeezed in the back, arms come back. And we're going to do this five times. That's one, number two. Keep that shoulder down, forearms flat, very nice. And three. Good. Try to keep those wrists nice and flat. Okay. And number four. Good. And one more at five. Good. Michelle was a little bit challenged with this exercise, so we're going to make it a little simpler and stabilize her lower back. So we're going to bend both knees up. That way she's able to decrease the lordosis, the space between her back and the floor. She's going to rotate the pelvis. Excellent. She's going to get the hands back in the same position at 90 degrees of the shoulder and the elbow. Great. And now, the same thing as previously, she's going to bring the arms back so the forearms line up flat on the ground. Fantastic. We're going to do this five times as well. Number two. Great. And if you can see that Michelle's arms are coming all the way flat and the wrists are engaged and flat now. And three. Good. And four. Great. And one more at five. Okay. Very good. The next exercise is going to be a full wall angel now with scapular squeeze. So you're going to squeeze your shoulder blades together. So it's the same position as we had before at 90 degrees at the elbow and at the shoulder. At both arms. And this time around, while keeping those arms flat on the floor, you're going to slide them up and squeeze your shoulder blades together. Great. And come on back. And when on the way down is when you really want to have the shoulder blades squeezed together. You should feel them come together. Okay. So we're going to do this 10 times. Two. Good. And three, keep those arms nice and flat. And four. Good. And five, squeeze the shoulder blades. And six. Good. And seven. Good. Keep those arms flat. And eight. Good, and nine. Good, and last one, 10. Nice and flat, squeeze the back. Very good. So the next exercise is going to be the supine wall punch. So legs are gonna be at 90 degrees bent. One arm is going to come up. You're going to lock up your fist and lock up your elbow. You want your elbow to be perfectly straight. And then what you're going to do is you're going to try to separate your scapular mobility from your shoulder mobility. So a lot of people will try to engage the whole scapula, and you're just going to use your shoulder to kind of punch the air. So your chest stays down, back stays down, and you're doing a small motion to punch up the air with your shoulder, keeping the elbow nice and straight. Okay, we're going to do that 10 times. And that's 3. And 4. Good. And 5. And 6. And 7. Dr. Lipinski just has his hand under the scapula to make sure that it's not moving, that the mobility is coming from the shoulder. And 9. And 10. And now we're going to do the exact same thing on the opposite side. So Michelle and I are at 90 degrees. Elbow straight. Fist up. Keep that scapula down on the floor. And we're going to punch up. 1. 10 times again. 2. 3. 4. 5, and 6, and 7, good, and 8, and 9, and 10. Very nice. This next exercise is called the baby get up. So what you're going to do, your forearms are going to be on the ground in front of you. Just like that. You can kind of form a small triangle with your fingers up front. Perfect. You want to keep your shoulders down to prep for this exercise. And you're keeping your neck and your mid back as one piece. So this is not an exercise where you're engaging the neck into extension. You're moving as one piece from the neck to your mid back. And what you're going to do is you're going to put the pressure when you lift up on your elbows. And you're going to come up as one piece. Hold for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3, while really keeping those shoulders down. And come on down. And we're going to do 5 of these. Shoulders down, head in the thoracic back, move as one piece, extend the neck, and come on down. And 3. Good, open up, extend that head. Rather, don't extend it, elongate it. And number 4. Good. And down, and number 5. Excellent. Good, and come on back. So the next exercise is the prone one arm elevation. So you're on your back, you're on your stomach, apologies. We placed a towel underneath the forehead just to make things more even and aligned. One arm goes front, the other one does as well. Elbows are locked, thumbs are up. And again, we're concentrating on relaxing and bringing down the shoulders and elongating the neck. And what Michelle is going to do is she's going to lift an arm. Let's start with the left while keeping that shoulder down, holding it for 5 seconds and bringing it down. And then she's going to repeat with the opposite side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and bring it on down. Very good. Okay, again, you're suppressing the shoulders, neck is elongated, and you're lifting the arm 3-4 inches off the ground. And number two on the right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and bring it back. Good. The same on the left again, number 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the right. Bring it down and then arm up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Number 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The same on the right. Number 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And one last one. Shoulder down, elbow locked, arm up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the same on the right. Shoulder down, arm up, elbow locked. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Very good. The next progression to the exercises, you're going to do basically the same exercise you did previously. Both arms are going to be straight, thumbs are up, and now you're going to lift both arms at the same time. So elbows are locked out. You're making a big angle between the neck and the shoulders. So you're decompressing the scapula. Good. Elbows are straight. And you're going to keep the head in neutral as previously, and you're lifting both arms up at the same time. 3 second hold. 1, 2, 3, and bring it back down. And we're gonna do 5 of these. So the same thing. Scapula down, arms 1, 2, 3, and bring it down. And number 3, compress, elevate. 1, 2, 3, number 3, great. Number 4, very good. 1, 2, 3, bring it down. And one more. 1, 2, 3, 4, and down. The next exercise we're progressing now is called the IYT. So you're essentially going to do the letters I, Y, and T with your arms. So again, you're lying down flat. The neck is nice and relaxed and elongated. You're gonna really push down on the shoulders and make that angle between the neck and the shoulder nice and wide. And then you're locking out the elbows and elevating into the I. 1, 2, into the Y. 1, 2, and into the T. 1, 2, come down and bring it right back around. We're going to do this 5 times. So compress the shoulders, the scapula, arms up, 1, 2, into Y, 1, 2, and into T, 1, 2. Very good, that was 2. Number 3, keep that angle nice and wide, 1, 2, into the Y, 1, 2, and into the T, 1, 2. Number 3, good. Number 4 coming up. Compress down, 1, 2, and then into the Y, 1, 2. Try to keep the Y a little bit narrower, 1, 2, and then into the T. One, two. Okay, one more all by yourself. Together, thumbs are up, compress, 1, 2, Y, 1, 2, and T, 1, 2. Okay. Okay, so Dr. Lipnitsky is now our floor sample for this next exercises. This one is the IYT with neck head elevation now. So he's gonna move as one unit from the neck to the mid back. He's going to elevate, not extend the head, but elevate as one. Bring up the arms into I with elbows straight. One, two, Y, one, two, and then into T. One, two, fantastic. Rest. Come back around. We're going to do this five times. Compress down on the shoulders. Elevate as one, one, two, Y, one, two, T, one, two. Number two done. Come back around. Okay, again, engage the elbows. Up, one, two, Y, one, two, and T, one, two. Number three done. Number four. Okay, pick up as one. Elevate, one, two, Y, one, two, and T, one, two. Very good. And one last one. Bring down the scapula, elevate as one, I, one, two, Y, one, two, and T, one, two. Very nice. All set. Next exercise is going to be prone lat pull down with head elevation. So we're going to use our knowledge that we had before from the prone baby get up, where the neck and the mid back are connected. We're going to lift up as one unit. Very good. Keeping the deep neck muscles engaged and keeping the scapulas down. And then Michelle's going to elevate her arms. That's it. And then do a lat pull down in that position. All the way down, squeeze the scapula and come up front. Fingers touch in front of her and come on back. And we're gonna do this five times. Keeping the neck and the mid back as one unit. Two. And three. Good. And four. Extend up, and one more. Shall extend those arms in front of you. Good. So progression to the previous exercises, we're going to add some resistance. So Michelle is going to be in the same position. She's moving the baby get up, right? So the neck and the mid back come up as one. She's now holding on to a TheraBand. Arms are up. Dr. Lipnitsky is just putting some tension into the band and she's gonna pull down. So pull down, Michelle. Good. Squeeze the shoulder blades right here. Good. And come on back. Nice and slow. Very nice. And we're going to do that five times. And two. Good. And three. Good. This is a little more challenging. And four. Good. And five. Very good. Okay, and relax. Next exercise is going to be the sideline in 90 degree stretch with arm at 45 degrees. So Michelle is going to be at 90 degrees at the hip and 45 degrees at the knee. And she's going to take the arm that's on the bottom arm, the arm that she's laying on to hold down her knee. The opposite arm is going to be elbow straight. And then she's gonna come on back. So there's a 45 degree angle. She's also going to rotate her head and look at her fingertips. Now, this position is going to be held for 30 seconds. And while she's holding it, she's concentrating on breathing and elongating her torso. make sure that you continue to look at the fingertips. Really want to reach, because you will get a little bit more mobility every few seconds as the body gets comfortable in the position and starts elongating with the assistance of gravity. Okay, and 10 more seconds. And done. All stretches should be done to both sides, so 30 seconds to one, and then you would flip over and do the same to the opposite side. This is going to be the posterior capsule shoulder stretch. So Michelle is going to be at 90 degrees at the hips and the knees. The main goal here is to have your body go over your shoulder. So if you're too far back, this isn't going to work. You're laying on your shoulder with the elbow at 90 degrees, and then she's going to push with the right arm, with the arm on top, down at the forearm of the left arm, and she's going to feel the stretch in the posterior capsule of her left shoulder. She's going to hold the stretch for 20 seconds. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. And relax. And you would repeat the same on the opposite shoulder, so switch sides. We're going to point out the incorrect way to do the stretch because it is often done, and we see it in practice all the time. So the incorrect way to do this, if you were laying off the shoulder where you can actually see the joint, and the correct way is when she is fully on the shoulder. So her body weight is over the shoulder, and then she's able to push down on that left arm to get the posterior capsule stretch on the left. This exercise is called T4 rotation in kneeling. Michelle's down on her knees. Forehead is gonna go down on the towel. Arms out front. Now she's going to start with her right arm doing the exercise. So left one is outstretched out front, not really bearing any weight. She's relaxed and she's straight here. One line. Now what she's going to do is she's going to rotate from T4, from that fulcrum, elevating the elbow with her eyes and her head following slightly. Bring it back down and repeat 10 times. 1, 2, the head is not rotating. Everything from the neck and the thoracic is moving as one piece. And 3. And 4. 1, 2. Mm-hmm. And 5. 1, 2. And 6. Good. And 7. And 8. And 9. Good. And 10. Nice. Now we're going to do the exact same thing on the opposite side. So left arm is going to be behind, left hand is behind the head. Everything is coming from here again. This is nice and straight and elongated. Elbow is going to elevate. Good, and rotate. And repeating it 10 times. And 2. Eyes have to follow. Good. And 3. Mm-hmm. And 4. And 5. Good. And 6. And 7. And 8. and 9. Follow with your eyes. Good. And 10. Good. Okay, the next exercise is going to be a T4 extension exercise. So we this is similar to the cat camel stretch, which we've done for the lower back. For those of you who have our video from previous tapings, this time Michelle is going to move just from her T4. So elbows are on the chair, arms are going to be elevated like so, and held in that position, and then she's going to drop in here and come out, extend. That's it, and drop in and come out and extend without moving her lower back. So we're going to do 10 of these. 3. And my finger is where you want the movement to occur. And 4. Good. And 5. Good. And 6. Very nice. And 7. She's keeping her back nice and straight behind her. And 8. And 9. And last one, 10. Very nice. This exercise is called shoulder protraction in Sphinx position. So again, Michelle is on her knees, arms out front, diamond up front, and she's going to protract from the scapula, all focusing around that T4 point. Just like that. And then she's going to fall back, keeping that neck and the thoracic back as one unit again. Fall and then come up. Good, and we're gonna repeat this 10 times. 3. Good, keep that head nice and relaxed, moving it as one. And 4. And 5. Good. Really focusing on upon protraction, really focusing on bringing that mid-back piece. And extending it out. And 8. Let's see, there's too much of a move. And 9. Good. Excellent. And 1 more. Fall through and extend right in here. And 10. Good. The next exercise is one of our more advanced ones. Dr. Lipnitsky is going to demonstrate it. It is called the palm up arm elevation in Sphinx position. So again, we're in Sphinx position on our knees. Rear end is up a little bit. We're gonna try to keep the elbows as straight as possible, as well as the arms, fingers slightly spread apart. And he's going to start with his right arm, elevate. 1, 2, come on back down. The same with the left. Elevate, 1, 2, come on back down. You're not going to get a lot of elevation off the ground, just about an inch. And we're going to repeat 10 times. And that's 2. And 3. And 4. As much palm rotation as you can get. 4, good, and 5, Good. And six. Good. And seven. One, two. One, two. And number eight. Good. And nine. Good. And 10. Very nice. Relax. Come on up. This exercise is called chest drop with straight arms in quadruped position. So Michelle is going to be squared where her knees underneath her hip, both sides, and her wrists and elbows are underneath her shoulder. Fingers are slightly splayed out. The neck is again in neutral position. So she's not tucking and she's not extending. She wants to keep this a straight line across. The next very important part of this exercise is you need to brace. So you need to kind of create a halo around your midsection, where if I try to push Michelle around, she doesn't go, she doesn't give. She's bracing right now and holding. She has very good stability. Okay, and now she's gonna go from the same T4 spot as we've been working on. She's going to drop down without bending her elbows and come right back up and extend to full extension. Excellent. We're gonna do this 5 times. And drop. Very nice. And extend up. Up, 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 up. Excellent. And 2 and 3. She's still bracing, so I'm not able to move her. And down. Good. And number 4. Keeping that head nice and elongated. And dropping, good, and 5. Full extension, good, and down. Very nice. Our next exercise is going to be a forward lean in quadruped position. So again, Michelle is in quadruped position, which means that the knees are under the hips, and the wrists and the elbow are under the shoulder. She has to, once again, engage that core. So there's no mobility here. And engage and protract the T4. So extend up, extend up, extend up, keeping the neck in neutral. Good. That's starting position. Now, what she's going to do is she's going to lean forward, lean her body forward, to the point where she feels like she's going to fall forward without doing so. And then come back. Great. And we're going to do this 5 times. This is in full protraction and the neck is in neutral position. 2 and 3. Good. And 4. Keep this up, 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 up. Good. And back, and 1 more, number 5. Up, 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 up. Good, and come on back. And relax. This is gonna be shoulder protraction with 3-point contact in quadruped. So again, Michelle's in quadruped position where the knee is under her hip and the wrist and the elbow are under her shoulder. She's going to stabilize the core as previously. So don't allow me to move. Excellent. She's going to protract at T4. So come up, 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 up. Excellent, keeping the neck in neutral. She's going to start with the right arm where she barely lifted off the ground. 1, 2, and come on back. Good. Keeping this in full protraction, repeating this 5 times. 1, 2. And number 3. 1, 2. Very nice. And 4. 1, 2. Good. Keeping this full extension. And 5. 1, 2. Very nice. Now we're going to switch, do the same with the left. Core is stabilized. This is in full protraction. So up, 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 up. Good. And lift the left slightly off the ground. Good. And two. Repeating this 5 times again. And three. Keep the protraction, full protraction. Three. And four. Good. And five. Very nice. Next exercise is going to be 3-point shoulder protraction with arm elevation. So once again, Michelle is in quadruped position. So knees are under the hips, elbows are under the shoulders, and the wrists are under the elbows. She's going to get into her brace position, which means she's going to put on her halo and her core, where I'm unable to move her if I poke her around. Then she's going to extend at T4. Extend, extend, extend. There you go. Up, 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 up. Keeping the neck nice and neutral. Full extension. And then she's going to start with the right arm. She's going to elevate it off the ground. Bring it up, 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 up. Nice and relaxed. Good. And bring it right back down. While maintaining the protraction here. Again, 5 times on the right, 5 on the left. And 2. Good, keeping this nice and steady, keeping the core engaged. And 3. Good. And 4. Keep this up, up, up while you do that. 4, nice and relaxed. Good. And 5. Good protraction here, good stability here. Good. And now we're going to repeat the same on the left. So again, stabilize, Michelle, before you go. Relax, stabilize. Good. Get your neck in position. Good. Protract to full extension. Good. And now elevate the left. Good. 1. And 2. Good. Keep this full protraction going. And 3. Good. Keep the core locked. Keep full protraction. And 4. Good. And 5. Good. Very nice. And relax. This is one of the most advanced exercises in the category where we're kneeling. We're now going to take away 2 points of contact and on the opposite side. So our starting position is in quadruped. Again, knees are under the hips and wrists and elbow are under the shoulder. Neck is in neutral position. Core is on, so there's full stability at the core. And Dr. Lipnitsky is going to lift his left arm and right leg, or opposite, right arm and left leg. Hold 1, 2, and come on back. Very important, we're going to do 5 on each side to have that protraction at the end without losing the core stability. And 3, if you see he's maintaining balance at the core and at the hip and his pelvis is not dropping. And 5, good. Now the same thing with the opposite sides. Good stability, protraction here, neutral neck, left arm, right leg, and 2, good, and 3, good, and 4, he's keeping good protraction at the shoulder, and 5, very nice, relax. Next exercise is going to be a shoulder stabilization exercise in sideline position with weight in hand. So Michelle is already lined up on her left side. What she's going to do is she's going to put a weight in her right hand. Now the weight can be a 5-pound kettlebell, a 4-pound weighted ball, or a 3-pound weight, whatever is available and again, the heavier it is, the more unstable you'll become. So it's a progression. The kettlebell was chosen because it's just easier to hold. So she's going to keep the shoulder protracted. So Dr. Lipnitsky is actually moving it into place. And what she's going to do, once that's fixated, she's going to make tiny movements up front with that shoulder while not losing that form. So you can go left, right, front, back, and just repeat. If you go in all four directions, 10 times. The key here is to keep that scapula engaged and not lose form. Good, and five. Good, keep form, and six. Good. And seven. Again, if you're getting very comfortable with the exercise and more proficient, the movements can become slightly larger, so you can have more degrees of motion, but you have to keep that scapula stabilized. We're now going to do the exact same thing on the opposite side, where Michelle is going to be stabilizing her right scapula, and so holding the weight in the right hand, so she's right sideline. Again, very important to keep the scapular stability. That is the whole point of this exercise. And the movements are, again, very small. Very good. Dr. Lipnitsky, again, is pointing out and trying to push that scapula in so it's stable and sucked into the thoracic wall. And again, you would do the left, right, forward, backward sequence 10 times. And let's go one more, and we're done. Okay, this next exercise is called scaption in standing with resistance. So Michelle is standing. She has her one foot on the TheraBand. Elbows are straight. Head is in neutral position. Scapulas are protracted. And she's going to, with straight arms, elevate the arms and spread out into a letter Y and bring down while maintaining good posture. Thumbs are up and down. She's going to repeat this 10 times. The key here is form. So neck is straight, back is protracted, elbows are locked. And three, and don't forget to breathe. And four. Good, don't forget to breathe. You're inhaling on the way up. And five. And six. Good. And seven. Good. And eight. And breathe. And nine. Great, and one more, and 10. Very nice, and relax. Next exercise is gonna be the scapular squeeze with TheraBand. So Michelle is standing with her feet shoulder width apart, 90 degrees at the elbow, neutral head, and the straight spine and back. What she's going to do is the TheraBand has already been wrapped. She's going to externally rotate her elbows and the shoulder, and she's going to extend out, keeping the tension and really focusing on squeezing in back. So that's the front motion, keeping the elbows close to the body, not letting those go. So do that once more. Great, and now we're gonna ask you to turn around so we can see the scapular squeeze from the back. Great, shoulder width apart, elbows tucked, 90, 90, separate the legs a little bit more. That's it, and neutral spine, and squeeze. Come back and squeeze, excellent, and back. And we're going to repeat this 10 times. And two, great. And three, good, nice and neutral. And four, very good. And five, good, keeping those elbows nice and tucked. And six, very nice. And seven, keep those elbows at 90, don't let them come up. Good. And eight, squeeze, good. And nine, good. Wanna keep those elbows at 90 degrees, don't let them raise up. And last one, 10, squeeze, squeeze, good. And relax. The last exercise is going to be scapular squeeze with shoulder extension. Now, Michelle is going to show you how to wrap the TheraBand, which starts by laying over her thumbs here. Then she's going to flip her palms to face her, and then she's going to knit through them, and then she's all set with the TheraBand. Okay, now she's going to stand shoulder width apart, straight back, neutral neck, elbows at her sides with her fingers fanned out, and then she's going to extend to full length and come back. Good, and once more. Good, and then Michelle's going to turn around so we can see what her back looks like while she does this. Very good, okay, shoulder width apart here, separate a little bit. Good, neutral, neutral. And again, extend out. You're really focusing on squeezing those shoulder blades together. Good, and come on back. And again. And we're doing this 10 times. So this is number five. Good. And six. Make sure those fingers are nice and fanned. And seven, good, and eight, good, and nine, good, and 10, very nice.